Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about the remaining portion from spinal cord injury chapter. So today we will discuss about the active rehabilitation phase. So first you have to go through this video and through your books also to prepare your own note, okay, which you can refer it later. So the goal of the active rehabilitation should be made as per the individual needs. Okay, by considering the level of lesion and the extent of injury of the spine. Okay, and the goal should be also made on the basis of the examination finding of the spinal cord injury patient. So, what is the physiotherapy intervention? So, during this rehabilitation, the emphasis of the treatment is to maximize the physical independence. Means to increase the functional abilities of the patient, and which includes bed mobility, transfer and wheelchair skills. Individual who are not able to do specific function, then the attender should be educated and demonstrated to do that particular specific function. Okay, then during this period the first exercise is given to the patient to continue the exercise which is previously prescribed during the acute period of the treatment, okay, which are basically the respiratory management, range of motion exercises, positioning, progressive resisted exercise for innervated muscles. And during this period of time also the emphasis on the postural control, balance, motor control and muscle re-education is given. Okay, so and also the exercise is given to improve the aerobic capacity of the patient. So now we will discuss about the skin infection, how to perform the skin infection. So if in patient with high level of lesion, the attender should complete the examination. Means the attender should be taught and demonstrated how to do the examination of the pressure sensitive area of the body. If patient is able to do, then patient should use long handle and adaptive mirror or wall mount mirror to inspect the pressure sensitive area of the body. Okay, then we'll discuss about the MAT program. So MAT program means it is the sequence of activities used to achieve stability, control movement in a specific posture, and the progression of this activity should be made from easy to a difficult task. Okay, all the activities should be divided into smaller component. Okay, the MAT activities are individual specific based on the personal medical status. So basically this activity helps to improve the strength, functional range of motions, then awareness of this center of gravity, then to improve the dynamic balance and to help to develop a functional pattern of movement. Functional pattern of movement means by utilizing the innervated muscle of the body, how the person can move the denervated part of the body. Okay. So the method of doing a functional activity may vary from person to person. So all the MAT activities should be designed on the basis of the personal needs. Okay, by considering the patient's medical status and age, like genders and premorbid condition also. So now we will discuss about the rolling activity. Okay, so it's rolling activity improves the bed mobility and it is a preparatory position to how to perform the position change. Okay, and also it helps to do the lower extremity dressing. So patients should be taught to use bilateral upper extremity, head, neck to produce momentum of the bilateral or to move the bilateral lower extremity. If first patient is unable to do any specific task independently, then the adaptive devices should be used to complete that particular task. Okay. So how to perform a rolling activity? First, the patient has to outstretch both the bilateral upper extremity and move it from side to side. Okay. In a pendular fashion. Okay, once sufficient momentum achieved or create sufficient movement, then the patient has to forcibly touch to the rolling side. Okay, so the facilitation by facilitation of this rolling activity can be done by placing pillow below the scapula area or below the pelvis area. Or patient or therapist can cross one leg over the other leg of the patient, or during the time of doing this rolling activity, therapist can assist the patient by giving little bit force towards the rolling side on the patient's body. Okay, then we'll discuss about the prone on elbow. So it's basically help to assume a quadruped and sitting position. Okay, so and what is the benefits of this prone on elbow? So it basically facilitated the head and neck control and co-contraction of the muscles around the shoulder joint and around the scapula. Okay, so how to perform this prone on elbow activity? So patient first has to push the mat with the elbow, then shift weight from side to side. Okay, and move one by one hand alternatively towards the head. Okay, and the other method of to confirm to do this exercise is to complete this activity by first patient has to push with the elbow to the mat, then patient has to move his body towards the leg, okay, until the shoulder reach above the elbow. Okay, so the exercise, what are the exercise performed during this position? Okay, to improve the cove contraction around the shoulder joint. So the patient has to move the body sideways, okay, like shifting the weight from one side to the other side, or patient has to move the upper extremity slowly by dragging in different direction, okay, to challenge its posture, means to challenge the balance during this posture. Okay, also patient can strengthen the interscapular muscle by doing push-ups. Okay, push-ups by pushing on the elbow. So now we'll discuss about the prone on hand, and it is for the paraplegic. Okay, so it is basically to develop hyperextension of the hip and low back area, which is required during the standing and ambulatory phase of the rehabilitation. So it's not appropriate for the patient those who will be having lumbar or thoracic area injury. Okay, they may feel uncomfortable while doing this exercise because particularly this position means prone on hand, it increases the lumbar lordosis, which puts lot of pressures on the lumbar vertebrae area. Okay, so first the patient should be in prone position. A pillow should be placed below the chest. Okay, to make the patient means prone position by increasing the height from the mat to the chest level. Okay, slowly or gradually the patient has to increase the height from the mat to the chest area. okay, by putting one by one pillow below the chest. Okay, so the what are the exercises performed during prone on hand area? So patient has to shift the weight from one hand to the other to improve the balance in this position, and also to facilitate the co-contraction of the muscles around the shoulder joint. Okay, and also patient can improve the balance by moving the upper extremity one by one or dragging it in the mat in different direction, or patient can improve the strength of the muscles by performing strengthening exercise, and that is basically push-ups. Patient can perform push-ups. Now we'll discuss about the supine on elbow. Okay, so it is the preparatory phase to assume a long sitting position, and it is easy to assume if the patient will have a intact abdominal muscles. Okay, so how to perform this spine on elbow activities? Okay, first patient has to hook the hands under the hip. Okay, first patient has to reach towards the leg, then hook the hand under the hip, then pull up partially by contracting the biceps of that particular hand and shift weight from side to side. Okay, while sweeping weight from side to side, the patient has to move the other elbow and position it under the shoulder. Then the other arm also placed on mat in same manner as the first arm. Okay, so what are the exercises done in the supine on elbow? Okay, so basically weight shifting from the one side to the other side to facilitate the co-contraction of the muscle. So basically it's a very vulnerable position because it creates a lot of shoulder pressure, as it puts lot of stress on anterior capsule of the shoulder joint. So most precaution should be care should be taken or given during performing this particular activities. So now we'll discuss about the pull-ups, how to perform a pull-ups, and it is basically given to the quadriplegic patient. Okay, so it is basically to increase the strength of the biceps, shoulder, flexors muscles. Okay, and which basically this bicep muscles and shoulder flexor muscles, it's improve the wheelchair propulsion during the wheelchair skill activity. Okay, so an overhead trapeze bar can be used to facilitate this particular activity. Okay, so how to perform this activity? So therapist has to be there in high kneeling position by keeping leg on both the side of the patient on pelvic area. Okay, then therapist has to grasp the hand of the patient just below the wrist area in a supinated hand position. Then therapist has to command the patient to sit up by using the biceps muscles. Okay, now we'll discuss about the sitting activity. Okay, so both the short sitting and long sittings are essential for the activity of daily. So both the short sitting and long sitting activity should be practiced. Okay, so basically for the tetraplegic patient, okay, so more amount of hamstring flexibility is required. At least it should around 100 degree of SLR. If patient will not have that much of flexibility, then which leads to the posterior tilting of the pelvis, and the while sitting patient will sit on the sacral area, which is called as sacral sitting. Okay, so basically the sitting posture varies with level of lesion. So person with upper thoracic area lesion, okay, will not be able to sit in a erect vertical position. So basically they adopted a forward head with flexion of trunk while sitting. But in case of lower thoracic area lesion, okay, so the patient will be able to sit in a vertical erect position. So in tetraplegic patient, so basically they sit by in the support of both the hand. So they keep their both the hand in a hyperextended and externally rotated shoulder, and the elbow and wrist also in this extended position, and their fingers are in flexed position. Why? Because if the patient will keep the fingers in stretch or extended position, then the tenodesis grasps they may lose, which is because of the tightness of the long finger flexors, okay, of the hand. Okay, so basically they sit in the help of with the support of both the upper extremity. So patient without tricep function lock their elbow by using the shoulder muscle. So what they does actually, patient first they have to touch up their hand and keep behind their hand, behind their body. Then by using their shoulder flexors muscles, they have to they try to flex the upper. So in tetraplegic patient, when they try to flex the supported arm, okay, by using their shoulder flexors muscles, as their wrist and hand is placed on the mat, so it's act like a close kinematic chain, okay, so which eventually extend the elbow, okay. So it can be done without the help of tricep muscles. So how to perform a sitting activity from supine? Okay, so first patient has to go from supine to supine on elbow. Then patient has to shift the body weight from side to side, then thrust up one arm, okay, by so by shifting weight from side to side, patient has to thrust up one by one arm behind the body, okay. So it will lead to the sitting with the hand support, okay. After reaching that position, patient has to walk with the hand forward till patient reaches to a sitting erect position, okay. So it can be done from the prone on elbow position also. So how the patient perform this? So first patient has to creep sideways to reach the lower extremity. Once the patient reaches to the lower extremity, then patient has to hook the forearms under the knee of that side, okay. Then patient by using the biceps muscles pull to partial sitting position, okay. Then the thrust up the grounded arm into elbow extension position, then the upper arm also placed on the mat in extended position. Then from that position, patient has to walk forward to reach to a sitting position. So what are the exercises performed in the sitting position? So basically the alternating isometrics and rhythmic stabilization of the trunk is given while sitting in the position to improve the sitting balance, okay. The once patient sit with the bilateral hand support, then patient is taught to leave one arm support and practice touching to the other area, to the therapist shown area, okay. Means to reduce the upper extremity support from unilateral to none, okay. Then once the patient able to get a good stability on this position, then patient has to practice the throwing of the ball activities, or by moving the body, means moving in little bit in different direction, okay. Then sitting push-ups also can be performed to improve the strength of the interscapular area. Means basically it is the shoulder depressors muscles. Then basically the head hip relationship in the sitting position is also taught to the patient. It is basically by moving the head and trunk, upper trunk of the by moving the upper trunk and head in one direction, the patient can move the lower extremity to the opposite direction, like flexing the head and neck forwardly can move the lower extremity to move on the backward position. In same as if patient will extend forcibly the head and neck and upper trunk backwardly, then the leg of the patient will move in forward direction.